Hello, welcome back. Today we'll look at lesson 41. Do you call that a hat? 今天呢，我们来看课文的第41课。Do you call that a hat? 意思是，你管那个叫帽子吗？ Now, this story is about a man who goes shopping with his wife. 故事呢，讲的是一个男人和他的妻子一块到商店去买东西。Okay.Now, let's look at keywords and expressions. Rude. Look at oneself in the mirror. Whole. Remark. Remind. Lighthouse. All right. Now, before you look at the flash,I'd like you to look at the following questions. Keep these questions in mind. What did the husband mean when he said to his wife, Do you call that a hat? 丈夫在对妻子说 Do you call that a hat? 那么这句话它是什么意思呢 Why did the man regret sayingthat they mustn't buy things they didn't need. 这个男人为什么后悔说他们不应该买他们不需要的东西 Question number three. What did the wife say when her husband said that a man can never have too many ties?
当丈夫说男人有多少领带也不嫌多的时候妻子又是怎么说的呢
Do you call that a hat? I said to my wife. You needn't be so rude about it, my wife answered as she looked at herself in the mirror. I sat down on one of those modern chairs with holes in it and waited. We had been in the hat shop for half an hour, and my wife was still in front of the mirror.We mustn't buy things we don't need, I remarked suddenly. I regretted saying it almost at once. You needn't have said that, my wife answered. I needn't remind you of that terrible tie you bought yesterday. I find it beautiful, I said. A man can never have too many ties.And a woman can't have too many hats, she answered. 10 minutes later, we walked out of the shop together. My wife was wearing a hat that looked like a lighthouse.
Right. Have you enjoyed the story? Do you think you can answer those questions now?
好，下面呢，我们再来看看课文中的一些问题。
What did the husband mean when he said to his wife, Do you call that a hat?
男的对妻子说，你管那个叫帽子吗？那么这句话是什么意思呢？
He meant, the hat didn't look like a proper hat.
他的意思呢，是说这个帽子看起来不太像一顶帽子。
Didn't look like a proper hat.It looked like a lighthouse.
看起来呢，倒是像一座灯塔。
The second question. Why did the man regret saying that they mustn't buy things they didn't need?
为什么这个男的后悔说他们不应该买不需要的东西？
Because he knew his wife could say the same thing.About the tie he had bought the day before.
因为呢，他知道妻子一定会说同样的话，他不应该买那条领带。
Last question. What did the wife say when her husband said that a man can never have too many ties?
当男的说，男人有多少领带也不嫌多的时候，妻子是怎么回答的呢？
She said, a woman can never have too many hats.
女人呢， 有多少帽子也不嫌多。这个妻子用同样的话回敬了她的丈夫，而且呢句式也一样。A woman can never have too many hats.
Right. Now let's look at some language points in the story.
下面呢我们看看课文中的一些语言点。
Do you call that a hat? I said to my wife.
你管那个叫帽子吗？我对妻子说。
Call that a hat.
把那个叫做帽子。
Call something something.
把什么叫做什么。
What do you call it in English?
在英文中这个怎么说？注意。如果提问的时候我们要用疑问代词 what， 如果用 how 提问，那么我们就不能用 call 而应该用 say， 比如这里的 how do you say thank you in Chinese， 在中文中怎么说 thank you。 好，我们再看下一句。
You needn't be so rude about itMy wife answered as she looked at herself in the mirror.
你没必要这么说话不客气。我的妻子一边回答一边照着镜子。这里的 needn't 意思是不必怎么样，是一个情态动词，所以呢后面跟的是原形 be 动词的原形。好。
I sat down on one of those modern chairs with holes in it and waited.
我坐在一个新式的、满是网眼的椅子上等待着。这里的 with holes in it 是一个介词短语，它修饰 chairs。 再看这个句子。
I regretted saying it almost at once.
几乎我立刻就后悔说了这个话。
Regretted
后面呢要跟动名词 saying it。 再看一下 regret 用法。
I regretted that I had talked too much.
我后悔我讲的太多了。这里呢跟的是一个宾语从句，用 that 引导的一个宾语从句。
I regretted what I did.
这里的 what I did 是由 what 引导的一个名词性从句，意思是我后悔我做的事情。好，我们再看下一个原点。
I needn't remind you of that terrible tie you bought yesterday.
我没必要提醒你昨天买的领带有多难看。
Remind somebody of something.
意思是提醒某人什么事情。
These pictures remind me of what I saw in a mountain village.
这些相片呢使我想起了在那个山村看到的事情。
Remind me of
这里 What I saw in a mountain village 是一个名词性的一个从句。
Please remind me to give back your key.
请提醒我把钥匙还给你。这里呢是
Remind somebody to do something，
提醒某人做某事，可以用这样的结构 Remind somebody to do something。 好，再看下一句。
A man can never have too many ties.
男人有多少领带也不会嫌多。同样的这个句式表达，我们可以再看几个例句。
One can never have too much money.
一个人有多少钱也不会嫌多。
I can never have enough of ice cream.
冰淇淋我怎么吃也不会嫌够。
My wife was wearing a hat that looked like a lighthouse.
我妻子戴了一顶帽子，那帽子看起来像一座灯塔。
Look like
意思是看起来像什么。
Do I look like a liar?
我看起来像是说谎的吗？
It looks like it's going to rain.
看起来像是要下雨了。好，语言点呢，我们就讲到这个地方。那么下面呢，我们要来看看关键句型。在这一课中出现了几个情态动词的用法，比如 need, must, 以及它们的否定形式 needn't, mustn't。 那么情态动词呢，后面要跟动词的原型，但是可以跟不同的时态。下面我们就把课文中出现的有情态动词用法的句子挑出来，请大家看一看，来巩固一下。
You needn't be so rude about it.
你没必要说话这么不客气。
Needn't be.
Be 跟在 needn't 后面是原形状态。
We mustn't buy things we don't need.
我们不应该买我们不需要的东西。
Mustn't
后面跟的是动词原形。By.
You needn't have said that.
你没必要这么说。
Needn't 后面跟的是一个完成时态。Have said that. I needn't remind you of that terrible tie you bought yesterday.
我没必要提醒你昨天买的那条糟糕的领带。
needn't 后面也是跟动词原形 remind。
刚才我们看了在课文中出现的有情态动词的句子，情态动词的用法相对说来比较简单，后面呢跟动词原形。大家需要注意的是，情态动词后面还可以跟不同的时态，比如我们刚才看到的You needn't have said that. 后面跟的是完成时态。那么这些呢，大家在学习的过程中要多留心。好，这篇课文呢，我们学的是关于一个购物的一个小故事。关于购物呢，是一个很有趣的话题。
Some people say women often tend to buy things they don't really need.
有的人会讲，女士呢常常买他们不需要的东西。
Why? Because they just can't resist the temptation.
理由是说，他们不能够拒绝诱惑。
Do you agree?
你同意吗？另外呢，说到这个购物啊，我们有一些比较常用的词，比如说，只看看不买东西，英文中叫 window shopping。
Do you do window shopping yourself?
你有没有经常逛逛商店而不买东西呢？另外呢，不同的人有不同的购物习惯
，different shopping habits。
比如说，男人去买东西的时候，往往是直奔主题，那么他们对于女士花很多时间买东西，往往表现的是 impatient， 不耐烦。那么很多人呢还会 compare prices， 还会比较价格啊，货比三家。另外有的人买东西的时候比较 organized， 他们会预先的做一个 shopping list， 他们会把要买的东西都放在一个购物单上，这样呢显得很 efficient。 好，这一课呢我们就讲到这个地方， See you next time。